Vegas beat.
What's up, LIT crew? We're back with another lit video.
And it's your girl Cameron.
It's your girl Steph.
And it's your homegirl Sharon, sweetie.
And we're back with another lit video.
What's good?
What's poppin'? Hey,
what's up, y'all? We are back with another video, but before we get into it, you must like, comment, share, subscribe, and tap on that bell so you'll get notified every time we drop a new banger. With that being said, let's get into it.
So today's video is more personal. One of our closest, most loving person passed away. He was like a father to us. Sadly, that was the worst day of
our life,
you know. When we have a death in the family, it's never a good thing because we usually not always together,
right?
So when we do come together, it's out of like weddings or funeral or things like that. But I guess we're going more into depth into who this person was to us and, you know, growing up with this special man. Sadly, he deceased, gone. So,
Man, the funeral was really beautiful. We have vlogged the whole situation, but we really didn't talk much because it's just, you know, very emotional day. Basically, just to give you guys a little bit more in depth of what's going on and who these people are. Okay, so the man that passed away is we call her our mother, but she is my mother, our mother, cousin.
Yeah, like so, first cousin.
So, when me and Sharon was a kid, because at the time Stephica was in Haiti, we were in their house all day, every day, 24/7. They live in Miami. So we was always in Miami. They grew us up, you know, our mother too. And he was our father because our father, like we said, passed away. We were five. So he was one of our father figures that passed away. And, you know, it was just really emotional because it just happened, you know. But we knew he was kind of sick. So I don't know, man. It's tough, you know.
Yeah,
I don't know how to talk about it because it's just like, you know, it's once somebody passed away, you will never see them again. All you have left is memories, and it's just like, damn, that sucks. Like, you know, never, ever, you know, ever. That's
weird. I think as well the reason why is kind of like, you know, it's kind of tough is because we just took a loss prior to that loss. And, you know, and when was it? I think a month or so prior.
Probably, yeah.
And it's in the same side of the family, which is all grandma family, all grandma sisters. It was another grandma sister husband that passed again. It might seem very confusing, but all family, it's like, I don't know how to explain it, but even though like you're a cousin or you, whatever you are, we stay really close to each other,
right?
As far as like respect, because we grew up in a Haitian household. As far as respect is concerned, even if you're a cousin, you like an uncle, we have to show that respect.
Right.
So he's kind of like, he was kind of like a great, one of the great parents. Like you look at him in the great parents family, like. And we lost two from that same generation.
Yeah.
So it was kind of like, okay, one passed and another one passed. So it was kind of hitting the family really, really harsh. Cause the first funeral, we wasn't able to make it cause we was in Houston.
Yeah.
And he passed the day that we actually was taking a flight to come to Fort Lauderdale. So it was kind of harsh on the family. And our great aunt, she lost a son, you know, a while back as well. So it's like now for her to lose her husband, it's kind of like
tough
on her because, you know, you don't want to lose. Those are men. Those are her strong men that she had around her. So to wake up every day and not have those people is, you know, really tough. Like we said, we're Haitians. We're really, really, really big on family. And even sometimes we don't see each other much, but funerals, everybody gonna show up.
Regardless.
Like weddings or any type of celebration, that's when everybody kind of comes together and, you know, just be there for each other. But
yeah, it was pretty tough.
It was a beautiful funeral though. It was beautiful, gorgeous. They actually had a horse, a carriage. Just a carriage. His casket was inside the carriage. It was. We had dove. We had to open the dove.
Do we have a clip of that too?
Maybe. I have a clip, but it didn't show when we had opened it.
Okay. Yeah, I had a clip. I don't know if my clip showed when it opened because I was trying to catch it, but it was so much going on that I don't know. It was so much going on, y'all. We were trying to catch enough footage, but at the same time
we still going through.
Yeah, it was like okay, we had to keep snapping out of the moment because when you're recording, you kind of like
gotta stay focused and try to. But it's like in reality, like this is, you know, someone important that passed away, so it's just like okay, hold on, let me start recording because I need to get myself together. We have family that's dropping and crying and still gotta make sure they are straight, you know. Haitian funeral is very, very different.
Very deep.
Very deep, very personal. It goes down to the core. Like,
Sometimes they can't even stand up. Like, it's, because family is the number one thing in our culture. Like, family is all we have, all we need, you know, to survive this world. So when someone passed away that's really close to us, it hits another part of you that you never thought exists, you know. It was a very, 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 very hard day for us because that's the same day we book our flight to come down, the same day we found out he passed away. So it was not a good feeling at all because we didn't even fully healed from the previous funeral that we had to go through. So the fact that we had another one hit us was kind of crazy.
And they both was a father figure too.
Yes,
both of them were our father figures. So
especially when you're not raised with a dad, so any father figure, any male in your life, you're gonna take them like, you're my dad. Like, I don't care, you're my uncle. My uncles are my dad, my mom friends are my dad. Like, anyone that's like help us or like be there for us, they're like another father figure.
Yeah, and that's the thing with Haitians too. Like, even though this person didn't help you in a way that you remember, if they helped your mom or your sister or somebody around you, around your family with something growing up in life, that's somebody they raised you to have respect for. So it's like we literally lost somebody from generation that our mom looked up to. Like, hey, this person right here, they the one who pulled me through. If I'm here, if I'm alive, making sure you're straight is because of this person. So we really had to make sure we were there through all that to make sure we support our moms because they the one who really got a chance to. Well, me personally, I didn't really grow up with him, but I know for sure that's somebody I grew up knowing that name.
Right.
And when I did come down here, that's someone, you know, I got a chance to personally get to know and things like that. And I think maybe a month prior to that, when we went to Miami, me and Karen, he wasn't feeling well. And we were in the room and he was asleep. So we wasn't even able to talk to him. And he probably didn't even know we were there that day. We only talked to his son. And he was like, yeah, he's not feeling well. He's resting and things like that. So sometimes I'm like, oh, I wished I went. When I went in there, I woke him up and like, hey, spoke to him and, you know, see how he was feeling. But I went in there, I was like, oh, he looked like he's asleep. I don't want to disturb him.
Yeah, I was like, oh, but he's sleeping.
Yeah.
Because we didn't want to, like, you know, disturb, you know, sleep. But I do somehow wish, you know, yeah, get up. I want to say hi. Yeah, I wish I said that. But, you know, when you see someone just
oh, he's tired, he's already getting, you know, a little sick. So I was just like, okay, every little moment he could rest and feel better, you know. But
so let's go into the clips. I hope you guys, you know, send out prayers to us, you know, pray for us, pray for our family, because it's like I said, we just got over, we're still not over the previous
and we also had another family member, which is, was a lady that passed right before the end of 2020. So it was like three.
So much going on, y'all. So much going on. So we just, you know, we just felt the need to record a little bit to let you guys into our more personal life, you know, outside of, you know, other things. But like, you know, just to show you guys how it is, you know, when it comes to us and how we handle
it. And also, if you're not Haitian, you can also see, like, the Haitian culture. Right. So, or how we handle funerals or how things go when we have situations like that. So I hope you guys, you know,
I don't even know what to believe.
But hopefully it brings you guys closer to us.
Yeah.
You know, that's all we can say is hopefully it brings you guys closer to us, to know us personally. And, you know, we just open up a little bit about who he was to us and who our family is to us and how much they mean to us, because the reason why we start off this YouTube thing is because of our family, especially our mothers. Like, my mom is my world. I do this for her. I do everything for her, you know.
And his wife is a big supporter of our
YouTube
channel.
Oh, yeah.
I call her mother, too. Like, literally,
call her mommy.
So
she was, like, our second mom. She took care of us a lot. Like, my mom used to, like, she had twins. And, you know, it was kind of hard. You know, she was from Haiti. When she came down, it was kind of hard. So they was there to help us a lot. So we used to spend months there without seeing our mom. So, of course, we got close to them and called them our mom and dad. So,
and auntie, which is their mom, she was saying, she always tells stories about how when their dad passed, that's who he basically was like, okay, take care of that. Y'all gonna be straight because he's gonna take care of you guys. Da, 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 da. So she was really deeply hurt. Their mom was really, really hurt about the loss of,
We can go ahead and hit the clips. And well, it was a mini vlog. So, yeah.
All right, y'all.
Oh, say hi.
Hi.
Hi, everybody. It's my sister. Yay.
And this is the flyer, guys. Oh, I'm not bad, dude. And we have all these pictures of him.
I had a picture of us.
Yeah. So sad.
see our beat.
La vie nous coûte. La vie nous coûte. Et puisque la vous coûte, sous seule façon pour casser vos lives, on va mettre la vie en danger. On va mettre la vie en danger. Dans Jésus. Et ça fait que, après midi, nous avons dit famille, condoléances, nous avons dit madame, nous connaissons une situation, nous connaissons une douleur. Même gens que dans le texte, moi-même que Job te dit, l'Éternel a donné, l'Éternel a ôté, que le nom de l'Éternel soit béni, soit béni. Bon Dieu bâille, bon Dieu prend, que nom mon Dieu béni. Et ça fait que après-midi, nous connaissons une situation. Même Jean-Jésus qui a consolé la famille Lazare. Et après-midi, nous avons demandé mon Dieu. Pour mon Dieu qui a consolé la famille Marie-Lys et Jelin et tant d'autres encore. Et que c'est ça fait que nous demandons au Dieu pour consoler. Pour consoler à qui perd tout Dieu reste encore. Nous prenons monsieur Jacques Allé, il quitte ton legacy, il quitte ton façon. Alors, ou même si tu as été remis à l'Empire, fallait des délégations. Il y a été qu'on fait. Moun y a été qu'on a été. Il y a eu un respect pour moun. Ou même respecter moun. Il y a eu remis à moun. Ou même tout remis à moun. S'il vous plaît, vous mettez mon secteur d'affaires. Merci. La parole est tout le monde qui dépose, frère. Je vais vous la prendre. Vous avez dit que vous avez déposé. Vous avez dit l'offre déposé, frère. S'il vous plaît, vous avez pour casser là. On va retourner bas pour que vous ne puissiez pas faire. Et tout de suite après nous sortir là, on va retourner la caille famille. On va retourner la caille famille pour nous rencontrer, chiter avec nous, manger avec nous. Et là, nous finissons de déposer les frères. On va traverser là pour nous faire une release d'offre. On va demander la famille petit pour nous aller là pour nous release d'offre lorsque avant de descendre casse brise. Thank you, thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. So,
it
was good to see people.
I think she was putting stuff in there. But maybe we should show them our family a little bit, like just glimpse and okay. around.
Say hi, mom. That's my mommy. And this is my other mommy. Mommy behind. Hi, mommy. She's really sad right now. Hi, mommy. That's my mom. Those are my uncles over here. I don't want to go over there because if I go over there, they're going to be talking in my ear. So the one in the, they're like eating for life. That's my uncle, my cousin over here. We have my other one. This is a whole bunch of families. We have more family here. More family here. And just family everywhere, basically. Ligas, beat.